In an attempt to save rhinos from poachers who murder and injure them for their horns, some veterinarians and conservationists in South Africa have taken the dramatic step of dehorning the beasts. While it may appear savage to take a chainsaw to a rhino's most distinguishing feature, the horn has no emotion. Rhino horns grow back like fingernails. Thus, the rhinos in KwaZulu, Natal province, where the program is being implemented, must be tranquilized and dehorned every year or two. In today's video, we're going to discuss why rhinos need their horns cut off. But before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on, so you don't miss out on any of the new videos that we post. Rhino information and why they're killed for their horns. A rhinoceros, also known as a rhino, is a member of the Rhinocerotidae family of odd-toed ungulates, which include the five current species as well as countless extinct species. Two of the current species are found in Africa, while the other three are found in southern Asia. The name rhinoceros is often used to refer to the now extinct species of the Rhinocerotidae superfamily. Poachers kill rhinoceroses for their horns, which are brought and sold on the black market and utilized as ornaments or traditional medicine by various cultures. The greatest market for rhino horns is East Asia, notably Vietnam. On the illegal market, rhino horns are worth as much as gold by weight. The horns are ground up and the dust is ingested by some tribes who think the horns have medicinal benefits. Keratin, the same protein that makes both hair and fingernails, is used to build the horns. The African rhinoceros, as well as the Sumatran rhinoceros, have two horns, but the Indian and Javan rhinoceros have only one. The black, Javan, and Sumatran rhinoceroses are all classified as severely endangered by the IUCN Red List. Humans are the only real predators of adult rhinoceroses in the wild. Big cats, crocodiles, African wild dogs, and hyenas can all prey on young rhinos. Although rhinos are huge, belligerent, and have a reputation for being tough, they're extremely vulnerable to poaching. They visit waterholes on a daily basis and can be killed while drinking. Poaching had escalated globally as of December 2009, while efforts to safeguard rhinos were becoming increasingly ineffectual. Zimbabwe has the most alarming estimate, claiming that only 3% of poachers are effectively stopped, whereas Nepal has mostly avoided the crisis. Poachers have improved their skills. Poachers killed the last female rhino in Krugersdorp Game Reserve near Johannesburg, prompting South African officials to demand for the immediate action against poaching. According to stats from the South African National Parks, 333 rhinoceroses were killed in the country in 2010, rising to 668 in 2012, over 1,004 in 2013, and over 1,338 in 2015. Rhinos are drugged and their horns are removed in some situations, while in others, more than the horn is taken and raises an objection to this behavior. The Namibian government has backed rhino trophy hunting as a means of raising funds for conservation. Annually, five Namibian black rhino hunting licenses are auctioned, with proceeds going to the government's Game Products Trust Fund. However, some environmentalists and members of the public are opposed to or skeptical of this technique. The horn trade. Since 1977, the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, CITES, has proclaimed rhinoceros horn to be prohibited. In October 2016, Swaziland's proposal to repeal the international prohibition was rejected. The domestic selling of rhinoceros horn was outlawed in 2009 in South Africa, which is home to 80% of the world's remaining rhino population. In 2017, a court decision reversed the restriction, and South Africa planned to establish legislation permitting the sale of rhino horn, which might include export for non-commercial uses. Some academics stated in March 2013 that the only way to prevent poaching would be to create a controlled trade based on humane and renewable harvesting of living rhinos. The WWF, on the other hand, opposes legislation of the horn trade since it may boost demand, while IFAW produced a research by EcoLarge that suggests that a better understanding of economic issues is needed to explain the pro-trade alternative. Why are rhino horns being removed to help save them? So it may sound very counterintuitive, but those trying to save the endangered species are purposely cutting off their horns, but we'll explain why. More than 7,000 rhinos have been slaughtered in South Africa in the last decade because of their gorgeous horns, which have helped to protect the species for millions of years. The demand for rhino horn, which is used for everything from traditional medicine to hangover cures and status symbols, drives the slaughter of over 1,000 rhinos each year in the country with the world's largest rhino population. The situation is critical all around the world. After the death of Sudan, the last male in March, the northern white rhino became functionally extinct, while the black rhino population has shrunk to 5,200. The situation for Asian rhinos is similarly dire. Only 3,200 Indian rhinoceroses, 76 Sumatra rhinos, and 60 Javan rhinos remain. There are less than 30 30,000 rhinos in the world, with Africa's southern white rhino being the most populous with over 20,000 individuals. These worrying statistics have prompted wildlife managers in numerous South African reserves to take the dramatic measure of slicing off hundreds of horns each year to prevent criminal syndicates from obtaining them. With the poacher's main goal removed, the risk to hornless rhinos is greatly reduced. Several reserves had dramatic results as a result of the method. According to Chris Galliers, chairman of the Game Rangers Association of Africa, roughly a quarter of rhino deaths occurred in private reserves in the southeastern state of KwaZulu-Natal between 2010 and 2015. However, this has fallen to 5% in the last 2.5 years, coinciding with significant dehorning operations. In the last 3 years, vet Dr. Mike Toth has removed about 1,800 horns from 900 rhinos in KwaZulu-Natal, which has been frequently targeted by poachers. Dehorning is not a permanent or optimal solution to the situation, according to Galliers and Toth. This is not something we want to do, said the group. It's costly and invasive, but we believe it's a necessary evil, Galliers adds, noting that safely dehorning a rhino costs around $1,000 per horn. The cost is determined by the use of helicopters and qualified veterinarians. Galliers, who is also the director of Project Rhino, an anti-poaching campaign, points out that dehorning must be done every 18 to 24 months because the horns sprout naturally. Even back then, dehorned animals were sometimes shot for their stumps. Toft has devised a procedure for extracting as much horn as possible from rhinos without inflicting discomfort or damage to their growth plates. On a huge bull, the horn is taken to roughly 3 finger widths from the base, then the stump is cut around the edges using an angle grinder, allowing an additional 2 kilograms of horn to be removed. The procedure is loud and forceful, but there is no blood, and Toft claims it's no more uncomfortable than clipping your fingernails when done properly. Galliers and Toft feel that dehorning rhinos in Africa and Asia could help save them. However, because of the cost, this may only be feasible in small and medium-sized reserves. It's not possible to dehorn merely a few bulls, since those without horns would be more valuable in territorial fights. All bulls are put at a disadvantage in parks where the entire rhino population has been dehorned. Dehorned rhinos, on the other hand, may still defend themselves against lions by using their size as a weapon, according to Toft. The goal of trophy hunters is to obtain both the head and the horns. Many other horned creatures are targeted, including elephants for their ivory, but Toft doesn't believe detusking is a viable option. Tusks are somewhat hollow and contain nerves and sensitive roots. Although the solid component of the tusk could be removed, a considerable piece of the tusk would have to remain intact, which could attract poachers' notice. Elephants also use their tusks to peel tree bark and dig into succulent roots and tubers. For the time being, dehorning looks to be working as an emergency measure, buying time as a decades-long debate over how to prevent rhino poaching continues. According to experts, dehorning has no harmful consequences for the animal's health. Dehorning or trimming rhino horn is not something that any of us that love these gentle giants choose, but it's a proven method of protecting the animals with little or no side effects or stress on the animals. Rhino911 wrote on Facebook, "Rhino horn is made of keratin, so cutting the horn is like trimming your nails or hair." The group added, "The horns grow back. Dehorning rhinos allows them to procreate and renew their population by extending their lifespans. The rhinos are regularly checked by experts throughout the process, according to officials, to ensure that their respiration and body temperatures remain stable." And there you have it. All the information you need to know about our beautiful, unfortunately endangered wildlife species, the rhino. It's extremely disappointing that people are willing to kill out an entire species just for a quick buck. Even though it's very invasive and doesn't sound like a nice experience for the rhinos, the act of dehorning these creatures is saving their lives, ultimately saving their existence. We hope that one day we won't have to do this and poaching will see an extreme cutback, ultimately becoming non-existent in the future, but for now, we're glad that there are plenty of animal rights activists and experts out there helping save our world with these ingenious methods. If you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to like and subscribe so you never miss out on any of our new and upcoming content. Thanks for watching.